Class 12 Miscellaneous Exercise Relation and Function. Now, question number one. Let F such that R to R be defined. Be defined as fx is equal to 10x plus 7. Find the function. Find the function g such that r to r such that Gof is equal to Fog is equal to IR. So here find the function G. So find the function G R to R. That means G function. So the g function you will get from here, that is y is equal to solution, that is y is equal to 10x plus 7. So y minus 7 is equal to 10x. So here save. So here y minus 7 by 10 by 10. Then is equal to x. This is g y, and therefore g such that r to r is defined by g x, that is equal to x minus 7 by 10. That means this is Gof, it is given Gof, and Fog it is given here. That means IR. So means G, this is the inverse of F. This means G, this is IR, that means G is the inverse of F function. So this is question number one. Now question number two. Question number two. That is question number two. Let F such that W to W be defined as Fn is equal to n minus 1 if n is odd and Fn is equal to n plus 1 if n is even, so that F is invertible, so that F is invertible, find the inverse of F here. W is the set of all whole numbers. Find the inverse of F, where W So f, here it is given, f such that w to w, and here it is given your fn. This is, it is given that n minus 1 if n is odd and n plus 1 if n is even. So f is invertible. You have to show that f is invertible. That means we have to prove that it is a 1-1 and onto function. If we can prove that, that means if we can prove, if we can prove that fn is 1-1 function and onto function, and onto function, if we can prove that fn is 1-1 and onto function, then we can say that f is invertible. Then we can say that f is invertible. F is invertible. So what I am going to do now, so I am going to prove that this is 1-1 and onto function. So let n1 and n2, they belongs to whole number. If your n1 and n2 are odd, if they are odd, then it will follow n minus 1 function. Fn1 is equal to n1 minus 1, and fn2 is equal to n2 minus 1. So for 1-1 function, fn1 is equal to fn2. So here n1 minus 1, this is equal to n2 minus 1. So n1 is equal to n2. Now if n1, now if n1 and n2 are even, if they are even then your fn1 is equal to fn2, n1 plus 1 is equal to n2 plus 1. So here again we find that n1 is equal to n2. So F is 1-1, f is 1-1 function. We can say that f is 1-1 function. So now from here we can say that f is 1-1 function, because for are odd and for even. And if we take n1 as odd and n2 as even, then your f1 will, fn1 is not equal to fn2. I'm going to tell you that if we take this n1 as odd and n2 as even, then your f and 1 is not equal to f and 2. So the question of 1-1 does not arise in this condition. So this is not, we are not going to take this, because we are not going to take this. We are not going to take this, we will remove this. Because to prove 1-1 function, your condition is that fx1, to prove 1-1 function, your condition is that x1 and x2, belongs to, say, for 1-1, the main condition is that n1 and n2 must belong to W, and your fn1 must be equal to fn2. This is the first condition. So if we take n1 odd and n2 even, then this condition is not satisfied. So 1-1, we can't prove like that 1-1. So this is the, in this way we can prove that it is a 1-1 function. And for onto function, let me go for onto function. For onto function, that is if n is one, the pens are not writing well, let me take another one. If n is even, then there exists an odd whole number, then there exists an odd whole number n plus 1 that belongs to W, such that f n minus 1 is equal to, if n is even, so fn minus 1 is equal to n minus 1 plus 1 is equal to n. That is, which implies that f1 we get 0. So f3 we get 2. So 2 minus 1, 1. So this will be 0. If n is 4 or 2, then 4, 4, 3. This similarly, if F4, that means 4. That means 6 minus n is even, no, so 2, 4, 6 minus 1, 6 minus 1, if n is even, then there exists an odd whole number n plus 1. Because our one minute, that means the function given to us is the function given to us is fn, function given to us fn is equal to n minus 1 if n is odd and n plus 1 if n is even, if n is even. This is the function given. So if n is even, then there exists an odd whole number, n plus 1 belongs to, if n is even, that is correct. If this is even, so there exists an odd whole number. That means there, and if n is even, that means this is onto function. To prove onto function, that means to prove onto function, my domain is n fn. Means my domain is n, and my codomain is n minus 1 or n plus 1. So, and this all they belongs to, means codomain is whole number and my domain is also whole number. So if I take any whole number, let me take 0, let me take this 0. If you take a 0, that means if you take a 0, that means so if you take 0, which let me do like this. If you take let this 0 belongs to whole number, so here since let 0 belongs to whole number, so what I am going to do this, I have to find the value, if I have to see if there exists any whole number in domain. This belongs to whole number and this is codomain. So I have to see whether this is codomain. So I have to see whether there exists any number which belongs to this domain. So if we take 0, that means to get 0, if n is even or to get 0, if we take like this 0, that means n minus 1 equal to 0, so n is equal to 1, that means and this belongs to whole number and this belongs to domain. So similarly, if we take let 1 belongs to whole number, then your n minus 1 is equal to 1. So n, this is codomain, this is codomain, so codomain, so n is equal to 2, and this belongs to whole number domain. So what we find that if we take n as even number, then there exists an odd whole number n plus 1 belongs to W. That means our main objective of onto function that if we take any element for n is in order to prove onto function, that is the function given to is to us is this n minus 1 if n is odd and n plus 1 if n is even. So here, and we know that and it is given that whole number to whole number. So from this we can, for onto function, we can conclude that suppose for n is odd, for n is odd, that means f1, if we take f1 odd, so here it will be 1 minus 1, 0. If we take f2, then even, it will be 2 plus 1, this is 3. And if we take 3, so odd, 3 minus 1 is equal to 3 minus 1, this is equal to 3 minus 1, this is 2. If we take F4, then even, then that is 4 plus 1, that is 5. Now here we can do one thing, and if we take 0, that is even, so 0 plus 1, that is equal to 1. So what do we find here? What do we find here? That if we take odd, then we get this all, see, these are your codomain. So for every elements of codomain, from here we can conclude that similarly f5, this is odd, so 5 minus 1, this is 4, because this is odd. So from this we can conclude that from this we can conclude that for every element of codomain, for every element of codomain, there exists a pre-image in domain. So for every element of codomain, there exists a pre-image in domain. So therefore it is onto function. So the earlier proof instead of doing that, it will be better if I do like this. The proof I have done for onto the proof, the steps which I had taken for onto function, the steps that I have taken earlier, instead of proceeding in that way, it is better to proceed in this way. And so it is an onto function, therefore f is invertible. So instead of I'm going to repeat the same that the earlier I so for n is odd, f0, that is 0 plus 1, 0, it is here, you remove this, n is odd, I'm going to do serially, here 0, So 0 it is even, so it will be 0 plus 1 1. 1 it is odd, so 1 minus 1 0. F2 that is even, so even 2 plus 1 3. It is better. So from this we can conclude that for every element of codomain, this all belongs to the codomain, these are all codomains, codomain, there exists a pre-image in domain, pre-image, that is 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there exists, so it is an onto function. So what I am going to repeat again, the earlier step which I have shown you, the earlier step that is if n is even, if n is even, then there exists an odd whole number, then there exists an odd whole number n plus 1 belongs to W. Instead of moving in earlier step, you better remove this step. Instead of going through this step, the earlier which I had shown you, instead of going through this step, which there I had shown you that f n minus 1 is equal to n minus 1 plus 1, this is equal to n. Instead of moving in this way, the earlier step which I had shown you, instead of moving in this way, it is better to do to prove onto function like this. So it will be, this is easy and this is very easy, and it everything is clear. So it is better to prove the onto function in this way. So and you give these examples, and for every element of codomain there exists a pre-image in domain. So therefore it is an onto function. So f is invertible. This is better. If you prove it, it is better to do like this. You delete the earlier step. So now I am going to question number 3. At the same time, it has told that find the inverse of f. So I am going to question number 3. In question number 3, if f such that R2R is defined by fx is equal to x square, fx is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2, then you have to find f of fx. So here you see f of fx, that is x square minus 3x plus 2. So this will be equal to x square minus 3x plus 2 the whole square minus 3x square minus 3x plus 2 plus 2. So this is a plus b the whole square. If you do this a plus b the whole square, so this will be this is very easy. A square plus b square, a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 a b plus 2 b c and then plus 2 c a and here minus 3x square minus plus 3 is 9x minus 6 plus 2. So now if you solve it, it will be x4 plus 9x square plus 4 minus 6x cube, and this is minus 12x plus 4x square, 4x square minus 3x square plus 9x and minus 6 plus 2, minus 6 plus 2, here you see 4, minus 6 plus 2, minus 4 plus 4, this cancels out. So your result is x4 minus 6x cube, and here again 10 x square, and last is your 9 and minus 3, minus 3x. This is your answer. Now I'm going to question number 4. See question number 4. So here question number 4 again. So that the function your f such that r 2, that is x belongs to r such that x is greater than minus 1, less than 1, defined by fx, that is equal to x bar 1 plus modulus x, and x belongs to r is 1 1 and 1 1 and on to is 1 1 and on to function is 1 1 and on to function. So here your function, it is given that real number, and this codomain is belongs to real number, but such that here x is greater than minus 1, less than 1. This is the function which is given to you, domain and codomain. And the function given to you, fx, that is equal to x 1 plus modulus x. So So keeping in view this condition, it is given to you that is, we know that from here, we know that the definition of modulus, when this is, it is x for x greater than equal to 1 and minus x for x less than 1. This is the definition. So here x greater than and this. So first of all, for x greater than equal to 1, this is fx1 is equal to fx2, that is x1 and x2, x1 and x2 belongs to R. So your function is x1 by 1 plus x1 is equal to x2 by your 1 plus x2. Now cross it, x1, 1 plus x2 is equal to x2 1 plus x1. So x1, x1 into x2, x2, x2 into x1. So this is x1 equal to x2. This is for one case. And for another case, that is for another case, that is x less than 1, for x less than 1, that here it will be f x1 is equal to f x2. So x1 by 1 minus x1 is equal to x2 by 1 minus x2. You can say x1 and x2 belongs to real number. So cross it. Again the same condition, that is 1 minus x2 is equal to x2, 1 minus x1. So this will be x1 minus x1 into x2, x2 minus x2 into x1. So here we get x1 is equal to x2. So it is 1, 1. It is 1, 1 function. So this is 1, 1 function. So now we have to prove that this is an onto function. This is an onto function. So we have to take some precaution while proving onto function, because your onto function, it is the codomain which is given to you. That is, codomain is between for onto function, we have to take some precaution. That is, it is between, because it is given here between, that is, it is between minus 1 greater than x less than 1. This is your codomain. Yeah, this is your codomain. This is your codomain. So now, this is your codomain for. So so here when your you have to take some precaution, that is the, because your function, this is a modulus function of x by 1 plus modulus x, and your codomain is this. So let me do it in this way. Let x is equal to minus 1 by 2, because it is within this range, minus 1, x greater than minus 1, less than half. So let us take x is equal to this. This belongs to codomain. This belongs to codomain. So, so here half now, because here you see. There is one thing you see, that is for x greater than equal to 1, the function becomes x by 1 plus x and for x less than 1 your fx it becomes x by 1 minus x for x less than 1. So x less than 1, that means so here if we take minus half this codomain, because your minus half, and let us see minus half, so for minus half negative, so if we take x by 1 minus x, so minus 1 minus x is equal to 2x, so minus 1 plus x is equal to 2x, so minus 1, so minus 1 so is equal to x, and x, and this x this belongs to real numbers, so this x belongs to a real number. Similarly for less than 1, means less than 1 means this is x less than 1, less than 1, then your function is this function is, and if we take this belongs to, and if we take half, if we take half, then this will be x by this positive 1 plus x, so 1 plus x is equal to 2x, so again 1 is equal to x, this also belongs to our real number, this also belongs to real number. So we can conclude that for every element, so we can conclude that for every element of codomain, so for every element of codomain, that is x greater than minus 1 less than 1 there exists a pre-image, there exists a pre-image in domain, so it is an onto function. In this way we can do the onto function proof, because we have to think it, because your codomain is fixed, no, x greater than minus 1 less than 1. So this your function, this is your domain, this is your codomain, and the function given it to you, and the function it gets two value for x greater than equal to 1, this is, and for x less than 1. So let x we take minus half, because this, so it is, this value is less than 1, so I'm going to take the function this, because this value is less than 1, so I'm going to take the function this, we get x minus 1, which belongs to real number. And if we take half, then greater than, then this is the positive, means it lies in this region, positive, so for positive I have taken this, and so here again so from here with this 1, and this belongs to your positive, so this belongs to your real number, so we can conclude that for there exists a pre-image. So in this way we can prove question number 4. Now question number question number 5 or question number 5 let me take question number 5. Question number 5. So for question number 5, injective means 1-1, you have to prove 1-1. So question number 5 here. So that the function f such that r to r given by fx is equal to x cube is injective. I have tried my best to answer this question so that it is student friendly, because your onto functions, for onto function, that is your for every element in codomain, there exists a pre-imaging domain. So by the help of example, I have tried to prove it, and I have tried my level best to be the proofs to be student friendly. So here you have to prove this is as 1-1 function. Injective means 1-1 function. So this is very easy. You take x1, x2 belongs to R, because your codomain is real number. So fx1 is equal to fx2. So this implies that x1 cube is equal to x2 cube. So here you can directly write as x1 is equal to x2. You can do it in this way also. Some of the books they do it like this also. You can do like this. fx2, that is x1 cube is equal to x2 cube. So x1 cube minus x2 cube, this is equal to 0, that is a cube minus b cube formula. So here a cube minus b cube formula is a minus b a square plus a b plus b square is equal to 0. Here your x1 square plus x1 into x2 plus x2 square, this cannot be 0. So therefore x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. So x1 is equal to x2. So it is 1-1 function. So it is 1-1 function. You can do directly like this, but in some book you will find that they take this type of procedure as you like. Now, 6 and question number 6 and 5, they are asking only examples. So I am going to skip this questions 6 and 7 because they are asking only examples. So I am going to skip this questions. Now I am going to question number 8. I am going to question number 8. So here you see, what is question number 8? Question number 8, that is given a non-empty, it is given a non-empty set X. Consider Px which is the set of all subsets of X define the relation R in px, define the relation r and px as follows. For subset, for subsets A, B in PX, A, B in PX, A relation B, if and only if, A is the subset of B, and then is R an equivalence, is R an equivalent relation on PX? You have to justify your answer. So given a non-empty set X, consider PX, which is a set of all subset of X. That means power set, define the relation R in PX as follows. For subset A, B in PX, A relation B, if and only if A is the subset of B. Achha, this is the relation given to you. So you have to prove that equivalence relation. So equivalence relation, first is AA. AA belong to the relation. So AA, for this AA, that means solution A, we know that that is A is the subset of A. So AA, it is reflexive. So it is reflexive. Again, if AB, that is A subset B, if A is the subset of B, then which implies that B is not the subset of A, because this is not an universal proof. If A is the subset of B, then B is the subset of A. It is not necessary. B is the subset of A. So it is not symmetric. Again, for transitive, so we can say that it is not an equivalence relation. It is not necessary to go for transitive because it is not symmetric. So we can say directly here that it is not an equivalence relation. So now I'm going to question number 9. So here question number 9 again. Question number 9. Let me change the set. Question number 9. Given a non-empty set, X, consider consider the binary operation, consider the binary operation, consider the binary operation star such that px cross px, px cross px, px cross, because we know that for binary operation px given, it is given by a star b is equal to a intersection b, a star b is equal to a intersection b for every a and for every a and b in px, for every a and b in px where your px, where this your px is the power set of x. So we have to show that x is the identity, x is the identity element for this operation, and x is the only, and x is the only invertible, x is the only invertible element, only invertible element in px with respect to the operation star. So here you see one thing that given, it is given to you that given a non-empty set X, consider the binary operation, this is the binary operation, and Px given by this A intersection B, your Px A intersection B for every AB in Px, where Px is a power set of X, so that X is the identity element for this operation. We have to show that X is the identity element for this operation. It's the only invertible element. So here, your Px, what is Px? This is the set of all subsets of X. This is Px. So a definition of identity element, that is E, this is E, B, let E be the identity element of star in Px, and your A belongs to Px, that is A is the subset of X. So according to your definition of identity, that is A star E is equal to E star A, that is equal to A. So here you can see that A intersection E is equal to E intersection A is equal to E. A intersection E. We have to show that X is the identity element for this operation. We have to show that operation, and X is the, so here this A belongs to X, so a star in Px, and A belongs to that is A belongs to Px, so A is the subset of X. Okay, so you are here, this is A star E, this is your definition. So intersection, that means A intersection E, this is put A. A. So for every A belongs to Px, so for every A belongs to Px, we have A subset X. For every A belongs to Px, we have a subset X, which implies that A, and this we have to show that X is the value. So your E, so this E, which implies that your E, this E, this comes clearly. So your E, so this E will be equal to X. Thus your, therefore X is the identity element. X is the identity element of star in Px. So X is the identity element in star Px. So because here you have to show that X is the identity element. You have to show. And see, it is given a non-empty set X, binary operation. It is given in power set. And here this, here A star A and B in power set. So Px is a power set of X. So that X is the identity element. You have to show this X. So int element for this operation. So X, so here is the int element I, and A, this means A is here, so that means A belongs to this power set, that means A is the subset in A, this A element, it is in X, or you can say A belongs to X, A is the element in X, this X. So A intersection A. So for every A belongs to this PX, we have means A belongs to X. So here, so E will be equal to X, E must be equal to X, your ID element is what? X. It is clearly, if you compare this, your ID element is X. Now, we have to show that, there is a second part of this question. We have to show that A is invertible. So, A is invertible. So, A star A inverse is equal to A inverse star A, that is equal to E, because if you do the operation, that means inverse, we get the identity element, and your identity element is X, your ID element is X, which you have proved earlier. So this star, that means your operation given is A intersection A inverse, that is A inverse intersection A. So this is equal to what? X. Now we know that this A it is the subset of X. A is the subset of X. So there is one thing, that is to prove it, that means A intersection A dash here, because A inverse, now we have to prove that we have to prove that X is the only invertible element in PX. So I am unable to explain you how to explain it. That is, I have taken this inverse A star inverse, so this X, so A intersection A inverse, that is equal to X. So here your A is the subset of X, because you have to get E. Because it is intersection, no. From this intersection, because it is intersection, so from this intersection, we get the conclusion that A is equal to A inverse is equal to X. So therefore, your X is the only invertible element of PX. So We have to show that x is the only inverse node in Px. So Px, x is the only inverse in Px. So Px here A, capital A, Px. Capital A, Px. So here, means A star inverse, you have to get the identity element x. So here star is intersection, for intersection common is equal to x. This is, and again A is the subset of x. So this is possible only when A is equal to A inverse is equal to x. This is possible only when this implies. So this is x is only invertible element in Px. Now question number 10. Question number 10. Find find the number of all onto functions of all onto functions of all onto functions from the set 1, 2, 3 ... n to itself. Find the number of all onto functions from the set 1, 2, 3, n and to itself. That means onto function to itself. Itself means number of onto functions is f such that a to a to itself. That means a to a, let this set be a, so a to itself. That means there are n terms. And we have to take all these n terms. There are n terms, that means the number of functions will be number of onto functions. Down to the n to itself. So same number, we have to take this n elements at a time. So number of onto function will be npn. That is npn, n factorial by n minus n factorial by 0 factorial. This is equal to n factorial. Now question number 11. Let S is equal to A, B, C and S is equal to A, B, C and T equal to 1, 2, 3. We have to find F inverse of the following function f of the following functions f from s to t if it exists. If it exists, your first f function, it is given that a3 b2 and c1. So here your f such that s to t, so from this is clear your domain is a b c and your codomain is 3 3 2 1. So here we see that so we have to find f inverse. So your f inverse is directly your f inverse, that is equal to 3a f inverse, 3a 2b and 1c. This is your f inverse direct, because this is this is 1-1 function and as well as this is onto function. This is 1-1. From here it is clear it is. So from this is it is 1-1 function. It is 1-1 function and onto function. This is 1-1 function and onto function. And onto function. The second you can do it yourself. The second it is you can do it yourself. Now I am going to question number 12. Consider the binary operation. Consider the binary operation star such that r cross r r and another binary operation o r cross r to r defined as a star b is equal to this and a o b is equal to a for a b, a b belongs to r, so that star is commutative, but not associative, and O is associative but not commutative, further so that for every a b c belongs to R, a star b o c is equal to a star b o c A star O A star C. So now here solution, that is A star B, this is called modulus A minus B, and your AOB, this is equal to A for every AB belongs to R. So let this AB belongs to R, so real number. So here A star B is equal to A minus B, and this is equal to B minus A, and so this is B star A. So this is congruent. This is congruent. So it is commutative. Commutative. Now again, your for associative, let us take A, B, C belongs to R. So here you will see that you have to see that it is a commutative but not associative. So that is A star B star C, this will be equal to A minus B star C, and this will be equal to modulus A minus B again minus C modulus. Now if we take A star B star C, so here this will be A star modulus B minus C, and this will be again modulus A minus B minus. So from this we conclude that it is not associative. Similarly for this AOB, you can prove it yourself. Commodity I am going to show you, that is it is easy. Let your A B belongs to R. So here your AOB is equal to A, but BOA will be equal to B. So therefore AOB is not equal to BOA. So it is not commutative. It is not commutative. Now here again, we have to show that, see, this is A star BOC. So A star BOC, this will be BOC. BOC, that means B. So this will be A star B, and this will be A minus B. Now the second, that is A star B B O A star C. So here again you see that this is A star B, that means A minus B O A minus C. So this will be A minus B. So here therefore A star B O C is equal to A star B O A star C. Proved. Now I am going to question number that is 13. Question number 13 is given given a non-empty set, non-empty set X, let star PX cross PX PX be defined as A star B is equal to A minus B union B minus A for every A B belongs to PX, so that the empty set phi is the identity operation star and all the elements A of PX are invertible with A inverse A. So here solution, let your A belongs to PX, that means A is the subset of PX. A belongs to the set PX, that means because it is, I will explain why by giving an example. I will explain it why. A belongs to PX. A belongs to PX, so A star phi, that is A minus phi union phi minus A as per your definition as given operation. So here this is a difference law, A intersection phi dash union your phi intersection A dash. This is your difference law. This is called difference law. So here A intersection phi dash means universal set, and phi intersection, this is your phi intersection, we get the smaller set. So union, we get the bigger set U. So this is equal to E. Again here phi star phi star E, that is equal to phi minus A union A minus phi. So this will be phi intersection A dash union A intersection phi dash, again difference law. Here this will be phi union A intersection phi dash is universal set. So this will be A intersection U. So this is A. So A star phi is equal to phi star A. So now here, so therefore phi is the identity, element of star in PX. Here you see the non-empty set X, this you define A star B, this A and B belongs to PX, so it can't be subset. A belongs to PX, this even. So now again A star A, that is equal to A minus A union A minus A. So this is a difference law, A intersection A dash, so this is phi union phi, so this is equal to phi. So therefore and star for all n A, therefore star for all element star anti operations and therefore all elements of A belongs to PX are invertible. Therefore all elements of A belongs to PX are invertible. Now question number, question number 14. The question given is define a binary operation, star on the set 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as A star B, A plus B, if A plus B is less than 6 and A plus B minus 6 if A plus B is greater than 6. So that 0 is the identity, for this operation, and each element A not equal to 0 of the set is invertible, with 6 minus A being the inverse of A. So here the question given to you is that define a binary operation this on the set this means this to this, and the operation is given so that 0 is the identity for this operation and each element of the set is invertible with being the inverse of A. So here A star, this is the solution, that means let your E be the identity element, so A, this is the definition, E star A is equal to A. So now here A star 0, that means here this is 0. You have to show that 0 is the identity, no? For the so identity, so A star 0 is equal to if A plus B. Operation is A plus B. Here it is given for this operation, that means for this is equal to A plus 0, that is equal to A, and 0 star A, that is 0 plus A, this is equal to A. So A star 0 is equal to 0 star A, that is equal to A. So here 0 is the identity element for this operation. So therefore 0 is the identity element. Now let B be the inverse of A. So A star B is equal to B star A is equal to B. So here A star B A star B, so B here from here, that is 6 minus A, that is equal to A plus 6 minus A, so this will be A plus 6 minus A for second minus 6, so this is equal to 6 is cancel, A cancel 0. Again your 6 minus A star A, that will be 6 minus A plus A minus 6, this is equal to 0. So therefore A star 6 minus A is equal to 6 minus A star A. So your 6 minus A is inverse of A for the operation, for the binary operation, So here you see again, that is question number 14. You see again, define a binary operation on set. We have to define a binary operation on set this. That means on this set, this means your star, this is the star, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, and the operation is A star for A plus B if A plus B is less than 6 and A plus B if A plus B greater than 6. So that 0, you have to show that 0 is an INT element for this operation. So this is the definition. So now your A starts in A plus 0, A plus 0. So this is A. And again 0 star, this is 0 plus A, this is also A. And you have to find that B is the inverse of A, invertible. Because it is even here, the set is invertible with this 6 minus A being the inverse of A, 6 minus A. So A star this, so B, that means 6 minus A. So 6 minus A, so here, that means here your A plus B is greater than 6, because 6 minus A, na? 6 minus A, that means A plus B is greater than 6, so here A plus B minus 6, you get 0, this will get 0, so this is the inverse of this. Now your last question, question number 15, your last question. Question number 15. That is, let A is equal to minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and B is equal to minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2. And your F and G such that A to B, B functions defined by Fx that is equal to x square minus x for x belongs to A and Gx that is equal to 2x minus half minus 1 and x belongs to A, R, F and G equal. These functions are equal. So here this is Fx that is equal to x square minus x for x belongs to A, so f minus 1, that's minus 1 square minus 1, this is equal to minus minus 1, so this will be equal to 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. Again f 0, 0 square minus 0, that is 0. F 1, 1 square minus 1 is equal to 1 minus 1, 0. And F 2, 2 square minus 2, that is 4 minus 2, that is equal to 0. So now again, for gx, I have to go for gx, that is gx, I will go for gx, I will go for gx, for gx here, that is g minus 1, that is the 2 modulus x, that is minus 1 minus half minus 1, so this will be 2 into 3 by 2 minus 1, so minus 2, so 2, g again 0, that will be 2, 0 minus half minus 1, so this will be 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1, so this will be 0. again g, that is 1, 2, 1 modulus 1 minus half minus 1, so 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1, so this is 0. G2, that is 2, 2 minus half minus 1, so this is 2, 4, 3 by 2, 2 into 3 by 2 minus 1, so 2. So these two functions are equal, therefore f and g are equal. So this is question number 15. Now question number 16, 17, 18 and 19, there are, these all are objective type questions, these all are objective type questions, this is your 16, 17, they are all objective type questions. So objective type questions, so question number 16, these are objective type question. Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3, then number of relations containing 1, 2 and 1, 3 which are reflexive and symmetric, which are reflexive and symmetric but not transitive, is which are reflexive and symmetric but not transitive, the number of relations. So number of relations, that means containing one to number of relations containing, that means A cross A, this will be number of relations 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Here, number of relations containing one which are reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. That means your relation set will be 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, reflexive and symmetric, that is 1, 2, 2, 1 and 1, 3, 3, 1. So number of relations. 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1. So there is only number of relations. So there is only one relation. So there is only one irritation. So there is only one reflex. See, reflexive and symmetric. 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. There is only one irritation. So now, question number 9, 18, 17, you can do it yourself. Let F such that R to R be the greatest, be the signum function, be the signum function, signum function we know, and G such that R to R be the greatest integer function, be the greatest integer function. So thus, then does fog and gaw coincides in 0, 1. So here signum function, that is for x greater than 0, your fx is equal to 1. For x, your fx is equal to 1. So now, greater than 0, x greater than 0, less than 1, unless this is close interval, this is close interval. X greater than 0, so for x greater than, and your gx, that is x. Yeah, this is greatest integer. So here you gaw g of fx. So this is g of fx, g. Fx means 1. So 1, for 1 it will be greatest integer function. This is greater integer 1. That means it will be 1. Now f of gx. So this is will be fx, greatest integer fx, and this is fx. So here fx. This is not defined. It is not defined. Is not defined. So your f of gx is not equal to g of fx. It is not. So does not coincide. Now, so does not. Does not coincide in 0, comma. So question number 19, that is number of number of binary operation, number of binary operations on the set A, B are number of binary operation. That means binary of star let this A is equal to A B, so star such that A cross A to A. So here your A cross A will be A cross A. So the number of elements in A cross A, that is equal to 2 into 2, that is equal to 4. So number of binary operation on this binary operation. So this will be number of binary operation will be n a to the whole power 4. So number of elements in set A whole power 4. So number of elements in set A, this is 2 to the power of 4, that is equal to 16. So star A cross A, number of elements in A cross 2 to 4. So the number of elements in A binary operation, number of binary operation, that is in set A, that is equal to 2 to the power of 4, that is 16. This is your answer. So this is over. If you have any doubt or if you find anything different or anything down, you can place it in comment section. And I have tried my best to make every answer that is student friendly. So this is over now.